almost claustrophobic atmosphere of that tunnel again as they come out, and a rather twitchy atmosphere, even for the most experienced players. And of course, Rangers have this great advantage. All of these players have played at the highest level, internationals, cup finals. Whereas if we look at the St. Johnstone side, well, certainly Georgia Boyle, as we mentioned, has played international football, but the only man who's played in the cup final is the man that we mentioned earlier on there, Paul Kane, who played against Aberdeen for Hibs back in 1984 on the losing side. A teammate of his, by the way, was Gordon Dury, good mate of yours, who's, after that Palmer game, convinced great runner, but not the natural goal scorer.
No, he's not. Better not talk about that game too much. Scoot Bonks had a fantastic chance, didn't he, near the end of the game, which should have taken Rangers with a terrific advantage to Palmer. That wasn't to be, and well, let's hope we can see a bit of good goals this afternoon, a bit luck.
Young man with the red hair here, now, Nick Dasovic, picked up for 50 grand, would you believe? I mean, that's like getting something for nothing nowadays. And I've seen him score two superb goals this season. He's used mostly as a substitute. Here he comes, a crowd greeting him, a crowd, I would say, roughly in the region of about 40,000, 45,000. Certainly, Celtic Park can hold something like 10 to 15,000 more than that. And Rangers, although they are strong favourites to win this, come in at a sense of parity, because it must be quite unique for a cup final, where both teams come having scored exactly the same number of goals, 11, and haven't conceded a single one, either side. If you like, St. Johnstone have to grasp at any score whatsoever, and they can say that they come with at least that level playing pitch to this final on the statistics of the League Cup final participation. And now we're picking up the atmosphere. Semeya, we've seen him play, we saw him play extraordinarily well against the Hearts, an elusive little player, as one might have expected coming from the football that he's previously played in.
Yeah, a real live wire. He can cause defenders any problem. Very, very quick, very sharp. I'll tell you, Sandy Clark will be very happy. This is probably the team he would want to play against Rangers, and this is by no means, yeah, okay, they are underdogs, certainly. There's a massive amount of experience in the Rangers team. But I'm telling you something, this will be a very good game for the Archie. Don't worry about that.
There's a cup final. Referee, Hugh Dallas, smiling there, very relaxed, of course. World Cup referee, another final for him. And not very much, he'll be affected greatly by nerves. I think most of the nerves will come from the younger players who are unused to this atmosphere. You can see Dick Advocaat right in the middle there, looking at his captain, Averuso. You could say, without being ungraceful to this man, that he does add eccentricity to his defensive play.
Just about. He does take a chance now and again, Averuso. I mean, he is a very, very good player. It's just that sometimes the fingers pointed at him that he's possibly a little lazy, or certainly taking a chance, but nevertheless a very good defender.
Well, I did say it was a family occasion. I think you've got a very brief glimpse of that. So here we are, Rangers, about to play in the 27th League Cup final. St. Johnstone have only been here once before. But at the start of that whistle, I suppose both sets of players with their own set of conviction about how this game will eventually break out. Rangers player there, that ball played round there to Gary Bolan, and who was brought with Alec Clerland to Ibrox. Clerland now with his former manager, Walter Smith. I think that ball has just gone over, and the sharpness and the quickness of this little man there, Rod Wallace, has enabled him to be Rangers' top goal scorer at this stage of the season, with the goals that have both been spectacular and very significant close up.
Absolutely, he's been really one of the finds of the season, certainly for Rangers. They got him for nothing, picked him up, few eyebrows were raised, but he certainly has contributed vastly to Rangers' start of the season, no question about it.
That's the ball, tries to touch that back to Samal. Kenahan testing the defence right away, and I'm not quite sure if there was any coordination between the captain and his goalkeeper there. He ended up with a black eye. Arthur Newman. Better ball inside to Ben Bronckhorst. He was badly missed, of course, and that's almost away. Badly missed against Palmer that night.
Great play by Van Bronckhorst. That's a very good play between Newman Alberts and Van Bronckhorst. Great early ball from Alberts. Cuts inside Giovanni. Has a shot, well blocked, and the first corner to Rangers. But again, you can see very quick, precise passing. St Johnstone chasing shadows almost, and almost the first opportunity for Rangers to score.
Barry Ferguson going out there. Well, the referee having been drawn across to push back the St Johnstone defenders in to get another corner kick. I think you're right in saying, Alan, that a lot of people have even tried to deride this tournament at the moment, but as you said, rightly said, most players would rather be here than not being here. And Rangers, although they have great priorities, other priorities, want to put this away. And Wallace! Well, the Rangers players are adamant that that touched a St Johnstone defender on the way through. But being adamant against you, Dallas, means nothing.
What a great chance this is. That fell absolutely perfect. Samoa was late in reacting. Wallace with force. Definitely a corner, though. Wallace is quite right. That's come up to St Johnstone man. But what a great chance. He doesn't really connect properly enough. It's a decent ball in. The big guys are up. They can't clear it. Comes back to Wallace. Falls. Whoa, gee whiz, what a great chance that would have been. Should have scored.
Gently touched on there by Philip Scott. Alan Preston was hoping to be playing in this final. Might have scored that glorious goal against his former team at Easter Road in the semi-final. Amoruso. Well, I would imagine that having done the homework and watched Amoruso playing, he didn't actually play up at Perth, that they want to harass him, get the ball at his feet, move him around a lot, which he doesn't like, obviously. Played straight down to Givash. This is going to be a very interesting combination between Givash and Wallace. We've seen how well the strong, youthful legs of Johansson has operated in combination with him. This is an entirely different setup. The Frenchman really still to prove himself. Alberts, Wallace. Well, the two times I've seen St Johnstone playing, they've been very impressive indeed in central defence. Darren Dodds has come on to a very strong game, as has Alan Kernahan, who creeps forward very effectively at times. Newman. Givash. Just a little bit hasty there by Alberts. Turned away by Philip Scott, who's seen a lot of the ball so far. Well, the boys St Johnstone knock the ball about like this, the ball will be certainly decreasing the sense of ball about this game, as Samar goes forward with a chance, and Alberts, of all people, coming back there, nicking the ball away. As Kane, using experience, tries to get into the box.
Well, it wasn't a great ball, actually. He's used the outside of his foot. If he plays it with his right foot, instep, right into play it hard and low across here. That's a difficult ball he's played, to be fair. They've got back to defend it well, Rangers. But really, Paul was right in with a better ball there, would most definitely have scored. Good play. Perini was a really, really deep there, Archie. Definitely played him on. And Amoruso and Henry have both moved down. Perini just stayed still.
Drives it in low, disappointing there. Ferguson right back defending. Alberts. Played that coolly enough. Both Alberts and Ferguson significantly came on to very much stronger games against Palmer in the second half. Here's Perini. Who I have to say had a dreadful game and admits it himself. He'll go for the run for Kinchelskis. The Russian is away. He can cut it back, can he? Givash! 6 minutes gone, and Givash, icily cool, puts that away to put Rangers in the lead, and that is so typical of the way he's finished so often in French football. Three seasons, he's ended up top goal scorer there. He kept his head well and his poise.
Well, he just said that on Tuesday, Archie, that Perini had a bad game the other night. He's played an inch-perfect ball. Kinchelskis is using great pace, and that just comes back. As a striker, you love that. Well done by attacking Chelsea's here. Good touch. Looked up. He knew Guivas is there. Bounces perfectly to him. Darren Dodge can do nothing. Bang, 1-0. Great goal by Guivas. Kaczynski's using his pace here.
Yeah, I think you'll find about Guivas. He hits the ball as cleanly as anybody I've ever seen. Now, I know he didn't do that to impress Newcastle. This is a different setup for him. Look at that run back in Chelsea.
Say something as well, actually, very important that, OK, it's not the most difficult to finish, but he has hit the ball very sweet. That'll do his confidence the world of good. Alan Mayne had absolutely no chance there, and it's an absolute dream start for Rangers.
He's a nice character himself. I know he's not exactly fluent in English, but he keeps himself to himself and looks rather dour at times, but I don't think that'll bother Rangers all that much. It's the sprinkle and sparkle in the feet that matters. There's Dasovic, oh, it's a great equaliser! The Canadian international out of the blue, that's so reminiscent of the goal he scored against Hearts in the semi-final, coming from just outside the box, and a build-up to what I think is now going to be a very interesting game indeed.
Well, what a goal that was. That's the job he's there for. When the ball comes into the box and it goes to the edge of it, he's picking up the pieces here. In before, I think it's Giovanni Van Bronckhorst. What a strike in his left peg. A little deflection. Colin Henry could do nothing. And if Guivas' strike was good, that's even better.
Well, I think about Dasovic is, in the past, I've noticed how well he comes from just outside the box like that, but he had a lot of work to do before making that contact.
Well, that's his job, Archie, at set pieces. You hang about the box. You don't let the ball, for scraps to be made. You make sure you make that ball yours. He did that. And not only that, a fantastic strike, and that's exactly the answer after Rangers taking the lead.
So, Dallas, I think, a little bit anxious about the position of that defensive wall again. I think this is an act of charity in George Albert's part. This is a sort of situation he would love to command himself, but it looks as if he's leaving it to Guivas. He is indeed. And I think Alan Mayne won't get that corner kick. He drove that pretty low there, the Frenchman. And quite clearly, I think that's an indication of what I said about him earlier. Rangers have confidence enough to give the free kick to Guivas there.
Well, the strike's a good ball. That's almost an art in itself, actually, striking a dead ball like that. And he's certainly got a bit of a strike on him.
Well, I thought he didn't get that, Alan, to be perfectly honest with you. Just touch back. The throw-in was given rather than the corner. And again, that looked to have got over this time. The assistant referee, by the way, let's call him linesman today, Alan. Let's go back to the old-fashioned way. The linesman away down the corner there. There he is, whatever you call him. He had his flag up.
Certainly, the ball was definitely out. Hugh Dallas has given. I think Rangers wanted a corner, naturally wanted a corner, but Hugh said it came off a Rangers head. So like it. I'm sure Sandy will be very happy. See two managers there. He'll be very happy. Not good to lose a goal so early against Rangers on a cup final. Getting an equaliser like that so quick. He'll be very happy indeed.
Guivas. 10 minutes played. Wallace tries to go through and Van Bronckhorst almost gets there. And this game is really sparkling now. That equaliser dramatically coming so soon after Rangers' opening goal has given us a tremendous impetus. Another one was about then wishing to go to Dundee United eventually, just after Paul Sturrock left. Looks a very stable man indeed, Amoruso. Taking no chances there, there's Kernahan. He might be the commander in the air to a ball like that to Wallace. Oh, they're picking up very well. There's O'Neill. Kane. O'Neill again. This is good play by St. Johnson. Put through to Philip Scott, and he couldn't get any real purchase on the ball there. And that's perhaps the best move of the game.
Yeah, good play. I mean, they like to play little passes. You see Paul won't play too many, you know, long passes. Nice thing to keep passing here. Very difficult to take it. That is going to be really magnificent strike to beat Niemi from there. If anything, I'd like to see him drive on and take the middle defenders on and make them make the decision.
That's a free kick.
But nevertheless, a very bright start, Archie, to the game by both teams. Perini just reminding Samal that...
Here we go, this is Kane. Shimao. Bellini with them, that's to the far post, and just a little bit overstruck there. And quite clearly they're going to be pushing the ball out to this man, a tricky little player. And the surface that I think should suit him today. This pitch was played on yesterday, that's Sandy Clark. Just, I think, a word of constraint on the officials down there. Well, imagine them getting sucked into the atmosphere of this frantic cup final. Here we are, that's the boil. Amoroso deciding to come away himself. Gives it away to Dasovic. Dasovic has played his football in the most exotic parts and trying to qualify Canada for the last World Cup. The one before that. There he is. Amoroso has a little bit of space there. Plenty of time for Bolin. Well, Dasovic really has been a saviour for this team, because they could have buckled if Rangers had really put the foot on the accelerator after that opening goal. Ferguson. To me, as if Amoroso wanted a ball played to him. Certainly came into this in a very strong position, both of them. They've now conceded their first goals of the competition. Colin Henry, around whom a lot of rumours are swirling just now about his future. Wallace almost got the touch, but they're picking the ball up well just outside their own penalty area. That was a hard tackle by Samoa, so I think he's proving he can stand up, be resilient under pressure.
Certainly Colin, no quarter given there, stretching out. Actually, I thought Colin was fouled just a moment before that, and that was the reason he was having to stretch to try and win the ball back.
More challenge in Amoroso as he comes forward. And the great thing about this player in the ball, just not Arthur Newman, is his ability to judge his runs forward, but I think he's probably being cautious about that this early in the game. Kane, look at the space O'Neill gets. Oh, he just overstretched himself though. Dodds, Kane. Now Bolin. Really, St. Johnson had to keep it bubbling over after that, and what they have successfully done is contain the likes of Van Bronckhorst so far. Here's Kanchelskis. Again, Kanchelskis gets criticised for not being absorbed in the game all that much, but when he does move, as he did very recently in the last game at Ibrox against Aberdeen, he can turn the whole match for you. Newman, Alberts with it. It's all a bit flat for Rangers at the moment and square, but here's Kanchelskis. Bolin, I think, taking a little signal from that first tackle by Colin Henry.
Well, they certainly caught him there, but I think every time the Rangers players got the ball there, the arms went up. They're looking for more movement to look to play, but I think we'll put it down to the good work by St. Johnson. They're working hard to make sure there's no space for Rangers up front.
Ian Newman. He's got pace, but he is very, very left-footed. Everything has got to come off, significantly come off that left foot. Amoroso's caught out of position now. Can they take advantage of that? Good tackle by Ferguson. Well kept in by Perini. Larry Ferguson, not a very good ball. Albert's missing out on it. Amoroso had wandered back into position. Givash is much, much more effective when he's playing from about 25 yards out from the goal line. It's Amoruso. And at the moment, a slackness developing in Rangers midfield in particular. Now, can Newman turn it here? Didn't really get hold of that. Well left by Neil Jamal. Trailing Perini. Good run by Samoa. They've taken great inspiration from that Dasovic equaliser. Oh, what a pity. The first touch let him down.
Yeah, you're thinking it's going to stick as soon as it's played into Jaws there, but just that time, just couldn't get the foot on it. Rangers get back possession.
Newman again. Watch the run by Wallace coming in here. Well read by Dodge. Simple, straightforward, big, burly central defender. With a harrowing time with Hibs last season. Jelskis. Trying to close Ferguson down whenever they can, and he hasn't got a grip of this game, and I think very significantly for Rangers, Alan, over the last three or four games, he seems to have shaded off, whereas previously a lot of Rangers' forward flow came from his intelligent play.
Yeah, well, you can understand that. I mean, he's still very young, actually, and there's so much put on his shoulders. But Advocaat staying faith with him, don't worry, he will be one of our top players, no question about that. Just at the moment, and maybe the last three or four games are just taking the toll a little bit.
Also initiating a lot of moves for Rangers from that position. Here's Newman. Ivash has gone wide. That's a little bit too near Alan Main. No real strain on Alan Main that time. Main developed himself along with Paul Storick at Tannadice. Shimao. He's had a very good game so far, and that's elusive quality coming up again that I talked about. Albert, Dasovic. They're closing them down, Alan. I mean, nobody's getting any time at a ball in midfield for Rangers, which is exactly what St Johnstone had to do.
Well, that's what I said a minute ago. It's okay, you know, if you give them too much respect, then they will tear you to ribbons. But you've got to work hard, you've got to make sure they don't go. Actually, that has come from Gary Bolan in the left-back area. The ball went to Kanchelskis, immediately shut him down. Kanchelskis had to go back the way, and everything else followed on from suit. And they've got to hurry and hurry, because if Rangers don't have the ball, so they can't beat St Johnstone. But they're working very, very hard. Having said that, Rangers are still having the dominance of the play. They, you know, they keep possession and things, but it's a bit more like a chess game at the moment.
Here's Wallace. Ivaš overstretched himself. I think he intended to put it back inside. There's a ball fighting very well for that, and that will be a free kick. Van Bronckhorst. Giovanni Van Bronckhorst, who I think has turned out to be one of Rangers' most significant players, getting embroiled in that there. Kernahan wanted to take that, but also haven't seen much of John McQuillan on that right-hand side, but when he gets tramping down that right channel, can be very effective, as we saw in a couple of games we've shown in Scotsport already of St Johnstone. Amoruso. Ferguson. Perini, a bit hasty with that, but Van Bronckhorst. Dasovic coming into him. And Rangers do have possession, but without any great impression of making menace near the penalty area. And too many of the balls played straight to St Johnstone's feet, coming from the likes of Amoruso. Here's Colin Henry. What's the running off the ball going to be like? Colin picks it up. beautiful little touch there by Wallace. Kaczewskis didn't get hold of it properly. And once or twice, the moves down the right-hand side have been spoiled by very poor finishing balls. But look at the space O'Neill has. Shimao beating Perini, skinning him. Colin Hendry read it well, though. Well, whatever doubts there may be in his own mind about his future, there was absolute conviction. Well, about anything he's done so far in this game.
I don't think you're certainly guaranteed 100% from Colin. But I do think he'll be a Rangers player for a lot longer than he will be Blackburn manager.
At the back, Kernahan. Amoruso just stepping in. O'Neill might let fly, little deflection there, awful boil. John O'Neill played so hard in the semi-final. Strong player, came again from Tannadice. From the Jim McLean's hard school. Shoot at them well. Just not how to play, but how to survive. Kaczewskis coming for it, and Main read it well. He was off his goal line as soon as the ball had left that foot.
Done very, very, very well, Alan Main there. I think he's going to have to be aware and certainly prepared to come and do that, because they're looking to put the ball in behind Gary Bowling for Kaczewski's pace to get in there. And Alan's almost going to have to play that kind of half-sweeper role to make sure that doesn't happen then.
Well, that was McQuillan trying to go on the outside. And quite clearly, the referee is going to have a word with him. By the way, the stadium is really filled up from kickoff. I understand there's been a lot of holdups in different roads coming into Parkhead. Oh, what looks to be a vast range of support around the stadium. Free kick. A lot of wrestling going on there, and I think the Rangers get the free kick. It's always going to be very hard with the ball in the air in that penalty area at both ends, with these the two tall, rugged central defenders of each side.
Yeah, I think the order of the day is precise passing up to the feet of Chester, your front men, because the two big guys at the back are going to dominate things in the air, most definitely.
Well, they don't seem to mind getting Amoruso the ball in the free like that, because he simply hands it back to them.
Archie Amoruso is passing from the back. Distribution has been absolutely atrocious. Dick Advocaat, if he had a lot of hair, be pulling it out, because he's been St. John's, with tongue in cheek, he's been St. John's best player, but well, quite honestly, his passing has been terrible.
Well, you're not stating something startlingly new this season, are you?
Well, no, I'm not. But, you know, if you keep on doing that, you'll find yourself sitting on the bench. Expect better from him than that, that's for sure.
It certainly makes life interesting. I mean, something that looks so prosaic and ordinary, here he goes again. it does make it so convoluted at times. You try to play football, I know that.
Then again, let me just put it down to St. Johnson working hard and reading the pass he's going to do.
Hendry. Givash decided to come back a little bit deeper, but as I said, he's much more effective for the forward. There's a run to Kaczewskis. Can he get the touch this time? And again, a little bit of a sprint by Alan Main there, showing that goalkeepers have to be nimble on the feet as well.
Well, we already spoke about it earlier on, but what it is a fantastically precise ball from Barry Ferguson, and Alan Main again did remarkably well. They are reading that they're looking to get Kaczewskis in down that right-hand side.
Look at the competition there. Shimao gets away with it. And to a boil, neatly put to O'Neill. That's a good tackle by Hendry. I know O'Neill felt it, but it was legitimate enough. Well, there's a bit of a turmoil in there. The game turning slightly, maybe that's a euphemism, slightly physical at the moment.
Certainly John caught Perini there. He thought he was going to get a foul, actually, from the challenge from Colin Hendry, but Colin's challenge was perfect, and I think just a little bit of retribution back on Perini.
is very deep. Dogs behind it. There's Ferguson. Perini, reckless the way he went in there. Now he does that little Marks pitch dive there, which really isn't the way to go about things.
Certainly causing him a few problems down this side somehow when he gets the ball. Perini hasn't yet got to grips with him. He's a decent player, he caused a few defenders a lot of problems somehow because he is very, very tricky.
O'Boyle, Perini, and that's where St Johnson are blocking him out in this area there. Gets to Kanchelskis. While Paul Kane has always been noted for his tackling, some of it has been rather reckless in his career, but when he's in the right mood and tackles cleanly and effectively, he really can turn out to be a great barrier for anybody coming against him. Newman. I don't think Arthur Newman had any idea where that would end up. He just wanted it put towards the penalty area. Here's O'Boyle. As Perini gets it this time, now he has on the outside Kanchelskis. Wallace, Perini coming up. Can he get the shot? And he can't. And I was saying about Paul Kane there, how involved he gets. He has great presence and he needed it there.
Yeah, he did again. I love the touch from Wallace, just helping it onto the path of Perini. And guess who? Paul Kane back defending, doing a great job. He's been a really good service for St Johnstone. Hasn't been there a great length of time, but he has done really well. One of the reasons they're in the cup final in the first place.
And the linesman down there telling them to push back a little bit. Of steam in that one, out to Kanchelskis. Only Niemi is in the Rangers half at the moment. Here's Wallace. He's very good in this position. This is where he caused Palmer great deal of strife. There he goes again. Good interception. Dodge right across very quickly to him. Well, he has been scoring the goals, this wee fellow, but it's good coming in from the left like that. And there's Guy Bosch. Maybe not just quite as bad a miss as Gordon Jury the other night, but almost in the same position.
Well, not just quite a bad miss. A great ball in. Good early play by Newman. I tell you, it's a great chance, Archie. He hasn't really got enough, he's certainly got enough on it, rather, but he just can't get it down. He's on his own, should be hitting the target from there. I suppose, really, he's trying to get a lot of power so he beats the goalkeeper, and in doing that, it's more difficult to keep the ball down. He's trying to hit the corner, just got it too central. Still a good chance, though.
Well, I think the heartening thing about this, Alan, we talked about this before the game, we were a little bit worried the Rangers took an early lead and then scored another goal on top of that, that the contest would wither away, but the Saints are up for it. They've got that great equaliser, and this is now looking a very even, even though Rangers have a lot of possession, a gay even cup final.
Well, most definitely, and I said at the start of the game, it's not going to be like, obviously, the 7-0 that happened before. Even in Friday night in extra time, I did say that I thought the Rangers would win, but definitely that St Johnstone would score. And it's going exactly where I think it's, you know, it's been very, very even at the moment.
Wallace dragged to the corner. That's an excellent tackle. Both of them coming off. And oh, dear, oh, dear. Ah, well, he did the hard bit. He dispossessed them. And as for the impossible. Guy Bosch, equally touchdown. Arthur Newman. Gets a corner kick out of that. The very left side of that, in the sense that they very rarely, these two players who combine there, use their right foot.
Well, I suppose if your left foot's that good, you don't need to use your right foot, but they are predominantly left, yeah, down that side. And another corner for Winslow. Took, to be fair, though, the McQuillan, etc., and Scott down that side have kept him at bay, really.
Yeah, there's a little touch on by Betts. Colin Henry up for that. Now, can Saints catch them on the break? Both Henry and Amoruso and push forward. Very cool cam play again by Philip Scott, number 21 international. Well, Georgia Boyle's not going to hang about. He was chasing after that. There's Burini. Ibash wanted it back. It's a little bit too hard there. Well, he appreciates the intent, but he misjudged the strength of it. Shows you how sharp Givash can be in a 1-2 situation like that. Yes, that'll be a free kick for Dallas, who has strode his way rather calmly through this final so far, exerting quite authority, I think you call it. Now, Newman. Thank you very much. Well, we're getting near Christmas, I suppose. Little gifts going on. From Rangers' point of view, too many of them. And you know, you've been a player in situations like this yourself, Alan. Rangers' hot favourites. I mean, hardly anybody outside Perth gave St Johnstone a chance. I think it affects favourites that way too. There's, you know, the edge has gone off Rangers' play in many ways.
Well, most definitely, yeah. And I think, to be fair, I will give again St Johnstone a pat on the back. They're making it very difficult for Rangers, and at times there's nowhere for them to go. There's still a long way in this game to go yet, Archie. A long way, but having said at the moment, certainly from the start of the game we had, things have dipped a little bit.
Here's a boil. Again, given away by Rangers' midfield. Oh, Van Bronckhorst. Left in the jet stream there. And there's Amoroso, he played that intelligently enough. Well, McQuillan has made these bursts forward. Quite sure the Rangers management watch that very carefully. There's Alberts, that's a gift again to Bolin. Didn't play that one out very well. Nobody challenging. Colin Henry coming forward there. Newman. Offside, I think. Well, Newman had run into the box to try to touch it back. Watch Newman coming in, heading in after that, but offside. Stefan Givash. So I'm playing for Rennes a lot in France. Team that was actually in the brink of relegation. He scored 36 goals. He scored 27 of them. It's amazing. In one season. Free kick. Referee wants that taken again, I think.
Six to one, half a dozen of the other there.
Looking towards Samao on the left-hand side. Givash is back, Alberts picks it up. Going again, Alberts. He has an immaculate touch with that left foot of his, but he doesn't really have that great acceleration. He can waft himself past the defender. St Johnstone simply letting Rangers come at them, getting every player behind the ball again. Perini went out there, tried to find Wallace. A little bit of interchanging going on now with Kinshelsa's having gone right into the middle. Wallace out on the right here. There he is. Bolin not letting him settle at all. But that's not the kind of ball you play to Kinshelsa's anyway. You've got to put it beyond the fullback.
No, true, but still Gary Bolin.
Well, that's a beautiful move as Alberts comes in. Oh, yes! That, an immaculate way to eradicate any criticism. You might have justifiably got slack play up till then. and a great piece of combined play as Rangers go 2-1 up.
Well, it's a great dummy initially, and Guivas just lays it into Alberts. At times it looks as though he just does enough, and you know he can give you more, and when he does things like this, you know he is a class player. Great dummy, beautiful 1-2 with Guivas laid in perfect for him. Defenders can't get there in time, and Alan Menn can't stop it. And we know when it's on his left peg, there's only one place it's going to end up, and that's the back of the net. 2-1 Rangers.
And we've seen three excellent goals. We're getting very near that forecast. Long, long way to go yet, Alan. Very near that forecast of 3-1 for you. But Saints have disproved our early theory that an early Rangers goal would cause a massacre, and it certainly hasn't been that.
But after that lull, it's probably just what the game needed again, and let's see what kind of response we can get from St Johnstone again. Because Rangers really had, not necessarily going through the motions, but certainly finding it very, very difficult.
And I also think Guivas has played a very significant part in this game, a goal and a layoff. Here's Ferguson, Kanchelskis. Again, played just a little bit too soon. And here's Alan Main with Guivas. Albert just stabbing it away. Amoruso comes in. Now Simao, they've got to strike back as quickly as he did the last time. Certainly cannot allow Rangers to edge in front again any further. McQuillan. You know, before this game, if you listened to all the critics of it, you'd have thought Rangers would just simply come out and sleepwalk and just gone through the motions, and St Johnstone would have been pulverized anyway. And we've got as good a game as I've seen between these two clubs.
Well, most definitely. St Johnstone are not a bad team. Must admit they are up against it today, certainly up against it now, being a goal down. But second half, Sandy will be getting them in at half-time, have a few words, see what the second half brings.
Here's Duman, Guivas, he's going to let fly. They got back there very quickly. Well, they haven't had any sustained pressure on the Rangers' defence, but it's just these occasional bursts by O'Boyle and Shamar that's keeping Rangers, and will have to keep them alert.
But that's exactly what Sandy will be hoping for. I mean, you're not going to keep possession, and you're not going to, you know, keep the pressure on Rangers at any time, but they will have, up to end the game, guaranteed a sustained time of pressure on them, and that's when they'll have to try and make it count.
Van Bronckhorst. Here's a lovely run by Newman. He's got Guivas and Kanchelskis in here, and up comes Ferguson. Loud shout from the Rangers support for penalty, but no such thing. That was a good clean tackle and no complaint from Ferguson, and away goes O'Boyle on the counter-attack. Henry just doing enough to touch it away, but I'll tell you what, Alan, that was a marginal one.
Very, very close, because he went to ground there and George would have been away, but he just got it, no more, didn't he?
Dasovic. That came off the posterior of O'Boyle. Now Perini. 5 minutes to half time, plus some stoppage time as Perini cuts that out. Now Ferguson. Away he goes, being a little more direct this time. Now Alberts. Newman. Oh, beautiful touch inside by Newman. McQuillan kept with him though. Alberts. There we are, there's so much good in him, as we pointed out with that goal, and so much slackness. What a mix.
Must have been a button in the dugout that Dick Advocaat's pressed, actually, because Rangers have just upped the tempo in the last 5 or 6 minutes, and all of a sudden St Johnstone, for the first time in the game, are just looking that little bit flat-footed, and they've just put a little bit of injection into the game and are now dominating as much of the game as they've had, Rangers. And we think Sandy will be quite glad to get them in at half-time just to break this up.
Wallace. There was a certain amount of indignity at the way St Johnstone suddenly struck back against them. They didn't expect it. Well, taught them a lesson. That's to Guivas. Has to drag it wide though. Perini. Go to Rangers. Vasevic. Well, I know. I think that with the important game coming up against Parma, it sometimes influences players, but they've got to put that right out of the minds, Rangers, at this stage. This is going to be hard fought right to the end, I suspect. That was a vicious swirl in that, and Alamein taking it with that superb clutch. The man who created a Saints record of 8 consecutive clean sheets back a season ago. Of course, captain of the side, very positive thinker about the game. Van Bronckhorst has been quiet so far, and that must be a booking for the goal scorer, Nedasovic. Yes. A bit of Cumberland wrestling. Yellow card.
It was actually great movement from Van Bronckhorst. He's gone one way, checked in. Dasevic knows that he's going to be away, and it's a little bit, maybe a harsh booking, because it's not necessarily been a bad game, but it's more of a professional foul booking than anything there.
He's had quite his game, actually, Van Bronckhorst. I mean, he's turned out to be a very influential player for Rangers, but today just on the fringes of the game. Couple of minutes to have time plus stoppage time. Van Bronckhorst, I think, intended to go on a run there as Amoruso is fouled. He just got away with that. Well, at times you feel there's a kind of lumbering contest between Henry and Amoruso when there doesn't seem to need to be.
And certainly, he does like to come forward with the ball, Amoruso, though, but he was definitely fouled there. But just sometimes, it looks as if he's very lazy, and sometimes when you play against defenders like Archie, you almost want them to get the ball, hoping they dwell on it, and then you nick it.
I think offside is given against Kanchelskis, and just as well for St Johnson, because he had that little bit of space of freedom on the right-hand side. There he is. Well, Givas ran away from that. Oh, just by a couple of paces. That's good play there by O'Neill. Colin Henry crunching in. No mercy there. There's a ball and almost taken by Givas. He may yet keep it in. He does. He's got Wallace inside him. Givas with it. Well, that's a poorish ball, though. I think he realises that himself. He did have a bit of freedom. He's not a very, very speed merchant, but he does place the ball well normally. That was a disappointment. Barry Ferguson again. Seems to be doing a lot of that. Either he can take it, or, and he does eventually, the touchback. And Bronckhorst, Amoruso was in there, here's Kanchelskis, here's a break. Dasevic, Hausimo, and would you believe, it's the halftime whistle. Right on cue. That was almost like for Rangers to rescue the 45th Cavalry that time when that whistle went, because he had no defenders back at all. And there's the man who made the game and took it on to parity, Nedasovic, followed by Givas, who scored that first goal. And here's the first point going in, Alan, very coolly taken.
Yeah, great cut back for Kanchelskis. Couldn't have shot the ball any better. 1-0 Rangers, Givas.
Now that's a good strike. Ooh, a little touch off the head of Henry there. Well, I don't think it would have made any difference.
No, it wouldn't. And this is the one that takes Rangers into half-time, a 2-1 lead. Good interplay by Alberts and Grievarts, and Alberts finishes with a left peg shot.
And there's the halftime score, a very tight, close, furious competition. St Johnson standing up to Rangers. Wonderful equaliser. And the halftime score, Rangers 2, St Johnson 1. Hugh Dallas about to start the second half. There are no changes in the teams. No substitutions at this stage. And the remarkable feature is, if you look back over the last 30 times these teams have met, there's only been one goalless draw. So this is, I suppose, living up to that record. Amoroso at the back, and one wonders if there is now more to come from Rangers, who would want to kill this game off as quickly as they thought they might have done in the first half. One or two players, certainly, in my view, playing below form, the likes of Brent Van Bronckhorst there, and if they get back into the groove, it may spell danger for this side. But again, having said that, St Johnstone, despite having lost that second goal, might have benefited from the break and a little word with the manager.
Yeah, I think so. I said just 5 minutes before half-time, I think they'd be quite glad to go in and have a few words with them. And I mean, they can't say they've played that bad, Archie. I mean, the goals were good goals. Certainly, Alberts is a cracker. Very, very difficult to defend against. And I don't think Sandy will be too disappointed the way they played. But obviously, they need to up it. They need to get a goal to get back into the game. Or the cup's going the other way.
Bolin coming in there to pick that up. Kane. Van Bronckhorst, can he send it away? That's a beautiful little chip. Wallace going right in behind there and touched away by Dodds. Then Kernahan. Not exactly the most subtle way to come out of defence, but it was effective there. And perhaps Giovanni Van Bronckhorst has had a little word in his ear from Dick Advocaat to get more involved. Certainly has been at the start of this second half. Well off the mark that time by Henry. O'Neill. Yes, they're coming into the ball with relish. Good concentration by St Johnstone. It has been a disciplined performance. And it took two excellent goals to put them behind, in fact, when you think of it. I mean, two well-carved goals.
Yeah, absolutely, that's what I said. I don't think they'll really be that disappointed with the way they've played. It's just that, you know, when they do get that chance to put Rangers on the back foot, then they're going to have to make it tell. Dasevic's goal was a cracker, and that's the kind of response he would like, certainly the start of the second half, to try and get things back onto an even keel. But just as I just said, just getting to the end of the first half, Rangers seem to have upped the tempo a little bit, and it just caught them flat-footed a little bit, St Johnstone. But they've had a break now, and I'm sure they'll give Rangers a bit.
That's ball, and now here's the break for Rangers. Going to be put to the outside, it can. This could be disastrous, and that was played far too quickly by Kanchelskis. That was more passing the buck than passing the ball.
Certainly, Weavars has gone offside. I think Kanchelskis anyway was trying to hit a long ball to Wallace, which he didn't catch properly, but not great forward play by Weavars when he's running offside needlessly like that.
Trying to play it just a little bit squarer there. That's a useful ball. Givash was standing behind Newman. Here's Wallace. Again, his first touch let him down. The Rangers always like to see Wallace with the ball at his feet coming facing goal and coming in from the left-hand side. A lovely little turn by Samal. Perini coming back at him, though. Yemi. Just got to that. Ferguson. Amakul. Boyle. Amoroso seemed to slip there. Got a play. They're trying to go inside. Finding it difficult to make the space, and nobody was on the right-hand side. That was disappointing. Ran out of ideas as well as steam at the same time.
Yeah, well, it wasn't a great pass, was it? Good play initially from Georgia Boyle, coming short, playing the ball out. By then, the chance was lost, and as they came across, he tried to find, I think it was Dasevic in edge of the box, but a woeful pass.
Henry trying that long one again, just cut off by Dodds. Here's Alberts. Givash. There might have been an arm used, but in any case, I think the linesman away across the far side of his flag up at Dick Advocaat. That wonderful rapport he has with officials down there, just making his point.
Probably Willie Young was trying to speak Dutch there, Archie.
think away the distance, Gordon Jury's been warming up, but I think it may be a little bit early in this half to be thinking about that. O'Neill again kept his head and eye over that ball. Newman. Always in any game, not least a cup final, Alan, this early segment of the second half.
It's been pretty scrappy, actually, so far. Not really getting into the rhythm that they had at the beginning of the first half.
Givash taking one right in the face, I think he's okay. He's played against some tough Aubrey's in France in his day, I tell you, especially down in Marseille. They don't take prisoners. Plenty of space for Ferguson that time. Wallace. Making a meal of it, rather. Van Bronckhorst came in. Almost got away with it. Sibal looking sharp again. Now, what can he make of the break? Dasovic. That's a very good ball forward. Oh, that must have been very tight, Alan. I think when the run was made right across there. Here we go.
Very close, we possibly don't just see. It may just have been offside, but actually the move has fallen before. They had an opportunity to play Philip Scotland a lot earlier than that, and they didn't take it, and that gave Rangers a chance to get back.
Well, I don't think that slow-mo's revealed it all, because I think his run was made much earlier than we saw there.
Correct.
So the camera can lie occasionally.
No, it's just us.
Nicely to Dasovic.
Not a great ball. You see Georgia Boyle signalling there. It's got to be into my feet. There's no point playing it over there. One, I'm not going to get it when the ball's played beyond like that. It has to be into his feet to keep possession for St Johnstone, because all they do is give the momentum back to Rangers.
A little bit of aggro there as a Boyle turns again and gets a freedom. O'Neill right into the penalty into Samal. Samal is given offside, but I wonder if he's thinking about the St Johnstone players much nearer him. Well, we said the camera sometimes lies. Let's have a look at that one again, because that must have been very, very close indeed again.
Well, I didn't honestly think it was offside. I think Advocat must be working him from the dugout, because I don't believe that that was offside. And since he's come out, he said he's slid up four or five times. Very, very close indeed.
Samal was not offside.
No, that's exactly what I'm saying. And very, very unfortunate for St Johnstone there.
Alberts. Well, Givash hasty with his ball forward. Boyle can't get it though. Always eager. Shows you how alert O'Neill is coming into midfield like that to pick that up. And they're stopping Rangers' flow very significantly, and O'Boyle has got away from his marker, and there's plenty space for O'Neill. Run forward there by McQuillan. I was eager to try that. Philip Scott again. And there's O'Boyle, and you've got a bit of freedom, and it just passed there. Kane wonders the wrong side of the post after he apparently had done everything right.
Well, just it was good actually that Boyle didn't make contact. Good control by Paul. Niemi doesn't, he's not going to save that. That's keeping inside the post if it's just a foot the other side. Good control, very quick snapshot. Defenders can't do anything about it. Niemi's beaten, but unfortunately for Paul, it just goes the wrong side of the post. Good sign for St Johnstone. If he can just keep a little bit of pressure on Rangers, this would be a good time for him to get back in the game naturally.
Alberts. There was a hand up there, yes.
I think he's unlucky there, Van Bronckhorst. There's no way he means to handle that. He's almost trying to protect himself as his hand goes up.
Sandy Clark, I'm quite sure, had some stern words at half-time, but he stands four square to the world, does Sandy. Speaks his mind. A hard time at Hearts, of course, and I've known him for a long time. He played in a cup final himself for Rangers. Very famous one against Celtic. What a medal. Look at the untidiness of that play at the moment. And again, it's eventually broken up, and I think Ferguson wanted to take it quickly enough. We'll leave it to Amoroso, and again, St Johnson making Rangers play only in flurries. Finding it difficult to keep possession, meaningful possession. Kaczewski's nobody coming towards him for that. So Johnson, much more creative with the ball at the moment. Simão, O'Neill, cut out by Amoroso. Rangers midfield has disappeared. And Amoroso is trying to explain that fact away to Kaczewski's. Well, who was to blame there?
Who will we blame?
If we go any further but Amoroso, somebody will create a prevention of cruelty against them. Now here, little ball touched inside. Albert. There's Ferguson. Disappointed in that ball forward. That's good play by Saints. O'Neill. Support by Kane. Olsen Johnson at the moment, Rangers simply cannot get the ball, and that is, of course, St Johnson's objective. Colin Henry. There's the run to Wallace, and it just got off again. And I think they're alert to the fact that these two men up front could make the break as they press forward. Panini coming in. O'Neill has played very well.
Yeah,
he's getting more involved than the likes of Brent Broncos.
Yeah, he's a good player, very, very good player. I mean, they need St Johnson needs everybody to be playing well to get back into this game. At the moment, they just don't really seem to be putting Rangers under enough pressure. And unfortunately, it's the time that will be ticking by that will be their biggest enemy.
Well, you can see from the clock there how far we've gone in this half. Encouraging moments for Saints, but I think very significantly, Anton Niemi has simply been a spectator. Hasn't been called upon to do all that much. Borge not giving anything away. Ferguson against St Johnston. Ending up with the ball, but Dasovic is down there. Really got that very hard, Dasovic.
He's going to win the ball. I think he's just fallen awkwardly on the base of his spine. Just feeling a little bit on his back. I think he's all right, though.
Well, he's Canadian international, but he's originally, or his parents are originally from Croatia. Came from Zagreb, so he has a good footballing heritage, to say the least. A little bit shivery down there, and I don't think it's a cold. Well, all Rangers are doing is popping it back into the St Johnson half to one of their opponents. There's Guy Vache. Again, not sharp enough, sweeping that away. O'Boyle, Simão. O'Boyle, can he get a shot in? Simão going right into the middle, and that is a dreadful waste of that. And I think he was caught in two minds, Alan, whether to go for it himself or sweep it across. Hence the result.
Well, they certainly couldn't have gone for himself, Archie. The ball's just too wide to him. But I think as he's looked up, he's seen Philip Scott coming in at the back post. I think he's tried to whip it round. You just see, you can see Philip trying to get round the back post. And I think his jaws was looked up, he's tried to whip it into the back there. You see the hands up, but that's not a great cross and not the great end for that move.
And Chelsea's missing out on that. Rangers at the moment give the impression their game plan has left the stadium. Somebody's put it in a pigeon carrier and sent it somewhere, because I can't see any shape or form about them at the moment. Here's Henry. Wow. Even Colin Henry placing that right across the field couldn't make it. O'Boyle put that in beautifully. O'Neill, Ferguson going back. Oh, there's a bit of jersey pulling there. Ferguson just gets that away. Well, I don't think there is the slightest doubt that Barry Ferguson, who's been booked more often than any other Rangers player this season, is getting involved there with the jerseys.
Well, I'd like to see that from Barry. I mean, he's not the most physical, but when he had to go back there, he had to make it very difficult for John O'Neill. Maybe he was fouling him, but he did enough to put John O'Neill off, and that was the main thing.
Kanchelskis playing centre-back. That sums up the last 10 minutes for Rangers. Shannon puts out Dan Amoroso. Here's a man we haven't seen for a while. His name is George Alberts. McQuillan. Alberts coming back on him. Arthur Newman just got it away. Ferguson. That's a better move by Rangers. Van Bronckhorst. St. Johnson have opened up because they had to push forward. Now Wallace. He's got to let fly himself. Back to Wallace. Blocked again by Darren Dodge. And that is the definitive danger for the St. Johnson team with so much pressure they've been having.
Yeah, absolutely. I thought that St. Johnson were having that little bit of sustained pressure that they might get a chance to score. And all of a sudden, a good move by Rangers sends him up the park. And Wallace finishes off with a shot that's blocked. All of a sudden, Rangers are kicked back into life again.
It looks to me as if Rangers might be making a substitution. They're getting Ian Ferguson warmed up. Barry Ferguson driving that in, but far too low. Back it goes. And I doubt very much if George Alberts is going to see much more of this game, because he scored that wonderful goal, but he's rather disappeared, and it may well be that Ferguson is going on for him. We shall see. Rangers get the free kick. As Van Bronckhorst will come across for that. The expert in the dead ball situation, wide on the flanks. I said expert.
Glad you said it.
Look who's back defending, Kanchelskis. This is what we call total football. There's a good spirit about St. Johnson. I mean, they really have made a marvellous game of it in the second half, without testing the Rangers goalkeeper. I mean, that's the substance of it.
Well, they haven't done that in the second half, even though, you know, that last move that Rangers had was finished up with a shot by Wallace. It's actually the best part of the game in the second half St. Johnson have had so far.
O'Neill. Well, that deceived everybody. Taking his time about this. Maybe not a bad idea. Here's Ian Ferguson about to come on. Fifth League Cup final for Ian Ferguson. Thank you very much. Another gift there, this time from Henry. Maboyle got his freedom. By Neil again, he has covered an immense territory. Colin Henry, I think Henry had determined this was going right over the standard necessary.
Yeah, good play by John O'Neill though. Rangers will now make that substitute.
It is George Alberts who's going off. He's scored his goal, he's made his contribution. What has been significant in that sense when he scored it since then, it's been minimal.
Well, he's been very subdued. The start of the second half, Alberts may even have picked up a knock, I don't know. It certainly hasn't really taken any part in the second half.
Dazovic. Ferguson put that away. Broken forward there by Ferguson, winning the first tackle of the game. Surprise, surprise. is Givosh. Well, the linesman down there seemed to think there was a slight deflection. Not entirely the consensus view of that group of supporters behind him.
Very brave man, isn't he?
Either play. I thought Ian Ferguson changed the game against Aberdeen when he came on for Rangers. Been playing very well for them. Van Bronckhorst trying to get the snapshot in, and St Johnstone have defended that very well indeed.
Tell you something as well, Archie, against Parma, Fergie was absolutely magnificent.
Yep.
Played very, very well in the second half. I mean, we all think of him as a little bit of a hard man. He likes to put a tackle in, but believe me, he is just as important as the Flair players. And a lot of people seem to forget that Ian Ferguson is an extremely good football player.
Yes, Amoroso just got away with it. Referee, I think, telling them to cool down here. He's in charge. He'll tell them exactly when the free kick is to be taken. Here is Ferguson. I saw him scoring a glorious goal in the Scottish Cup final for St Mirren. There's Kanchelskis, referee giving him the benefit. Quite extraordinary. I thought for a moment that ball had gone out. So saying to you, and I can understand why a lot of people criticise Kanchelskis, because he does seem to be wasting a lot of time, if we could put it that way, away in the fringe of a game. But again, you know, like against Aberdeen, he can suddenly come in 30 seconds, bang, he's won it for you.
Yeah, most definitely. He's certainly not actively involved for the full 90 minutes, but when you've got him giving you a bit of width, Archie, and certainly the pace that he can deliver, he's always going to be a threat in particular times of the game, and already has contributed by setting up a goal for Rangers.
That's a slag ball. Kanchelskis giving it away. Well, all the sustained consecutive passes have come from St Johnstone. There's O'Boyle. Ferguson has really made a difference in there. He's won more tackles in 5 minutes than Elbert's did throughout the whole game, and that is a crucial part of the game in midfield.
Well, this is where the games can be won and lost, and if you've got Fergie putting it about and they're getting the ball and making good passes, then Rangers will dominate this game and go on and win it. And, okay, in the first half, St Johnstone certainly worked very hard, but in the second half, Alberts was quite honestly a passenger for Rangers.
Yes, Ferguson is screaming for a ball to be played to Perini. Well, he waits for Ferguson to come back to him. Barry Ferguson this time. Here's Van Bronckhorst, watch the lead fly, goal! Well, that seemed to gather pace the further it went from him.
And the first time I've really seen him today as well, Gianni Van Bronckhorst, right through the legs of the defender. Alan Main coming across, very good goalkeeper, Alan Main.
It just seemed to keep adding pace to itself.
It was, wasn't it? It was certainly picking up pace, flew by the post, but really that's the first we've seen of Van Bronckhorst in the second half as well.
Now Neil. Also watching this very carefully indeed, and O'Boyle, who just come back after injury, by the way, he, I suppose he has to pace himself to a certain extent. Alan Main, enough time just to bring it down. He's normally very cool in these situations. In fact, I think he must, as a child, have wanted to be Beckenbauer, Alan Main, because he loves coming out and playing with his feet. Well, could they get that other goal?
It's a good shout there, Archie, when you said that O'Boyle was coming back from injury. You've just seen Sandy Clark saying to O'Boyle, "You're right, is everything okay?" And O'Boyle gave him the thumbs up. So that's still good news for St Johnstone.
Well, Rod Wallace, well, his touch has been pretty good for Rangers this season. Today's been rather ragged, his first touch in particular. That's meant for Givosh. It should be cut off by Kenneman. Who in midfield will pick it up for Rangers? None of these balls coming off for them. Simao, just a bit too strong. Getting to that crucial area, 20 minutes to go. Wallace, Almost got away from Dodds. Ivaš was hovering away in the right-hand side of the penalty area. So we have Vandrockers to take this. Nobody going towards him with any great relish. Wallace gets a corner kick out of it. As I said, vast Ranger support has turned up here today. I think St. Johnson may bring on one of the best buys of Scottish football this season, Nathan Lowndes. I think he's preparing to come on, the man they got for 50,000, and over it goes, and Dasovic forced to concede the corner kick. Yes, this Nathan Lowndes, I saw him scoring, there he is, saw him scoring a glorious goal against Kilmarnock. He was only on the park for about 3 minutes, and he came on against the Hearts and led them a merry dance. He's getting ready to come on, only used as a sub. Once again, that duel out there, Vandrockhorst, Barry Ferguson. Well, Hugh Dallas has been forced to come across by the linesman to judge exactly where the Saints defenders are. Vandrockhorst, there's a lot of curl in it. Guy Vaj puts it down. Arthur Newman with his right foot didn't get hold of it properly. And Amoroso comes in, just brushes Georgia Boyle aside almost contemptuously. Gary Bowler. Kane, a little bit much in that, just caught by McQuillan. Here's Vandrockhorst. Ferguson. Bit of hesitation there. Eventually, after a little bit of a conference, it seemed to be, they made up their minds.
That was the first thing. He took the ball by the horns there, Amoroso, did exactly the right thing. Clear your lines. I went to Rangers man as well.
Ferguson called into action again. Wallace. Look how deep he is, though. St. Johnson, I think, will be quite happy to see him parked around there. I can see they simply want to keep the ball. Kanchelskis trying to inject that little spurt again, which he's so very good at, but he's been so closely marked, and it looks as if Nick Lowndes is coming on. Nathan Lowndes is coming on. Well, I did say he was coming back from injury. Just got back to play in this final, and he's given 150% for his club. And on comes a man who's a different kind of player, but nevertheless, still snaps beautiful goals. Down to Ferguson. Just gets away from the tackle again. Supported there by Perini, and then back to Kanchelskis, to Henry. Newman. Judged that deftly enough. Vandrockhorst still wanted to go back the way, though. Football combination from Rangers here all the same. Alan, that was a centre-back shot.
But Rangers seem at the moment, Archie, just to be quite prepared to keep possession in midfield, not really make too many telling passes in behind, maybe to get Kanchelskis free or to play the ball into feet for the front two. And almost as though, you know, that they're playing these minutes out.
Yeah, but however, at 2-1, they don't want an extra time. They've got enough of the plate Rangers without that. So
absolutely.
St. Johnson make a goal, as they quite easily could, then that would be a dilemma. Here's Lowndes, Amoroso's there. dealt confidently by Niemi. Ferguson. Well, he's changed Rangers midfield since coming on. Little doubt about that. Wallace just got in the way of it. Throw to St. Johnson, though. Kane. Quillen. Up to Dasovic. Guivarch picked it up all right, but look at the... the greatly determined, more determined tackle there that came from the Saints player. Newman can't get it away. Here's the chase. And Henry plays it safe because the little man was going right through the middle, Shamal. And he may not be the captain, but he does have that dominant presence in that area.
I think Colin's shown Shamal a little bit of respect here and deciding that it was better to give away the throw than put Niemi under too much pressure.
Back to McQuillan, he judged that very well, and Ian Ferguson's there again. On to Guivarch. Sharply in again there from Dodds. I think Guivarch is going to require a great many more games before he gets into his true stride again. I think he's given up and getting an actual pass from defense. Dealt with so often, so competently by this Saints defence, that free kick. And it looks to me as if Alan Preston, the ex-Hearts player who has scored that one of the best goals of the season at Easter Road in the semi-final, is about to come on, coming away again. Now Lanz gets his freedom. Newman just sliding it, and there's Ferguson again. Great play by Fergie. Newman inside, and again drifting away from Wallace. Amoruso. Here's Guivarch. Well, they done well that time. Here's Wallace. Van Bronckhorst. Plenty of space there for Perini. He might just get to it. On to Kanchelskis. Now Perini. There's a ball across. And Barry Ferguson's there. Now Wallace just touched away. Here's the break. Shamal goes for it, but I think he got right out of the way there of Henry. And I don't blame him. Now Kanchelskis. Rangers trying to go in and kill this game. And Wallace just seemed to pull back in the trigger there. He didn't press it as I thought he would.
Well, that's when you know he's very, very dangerous. All of a sudden, he injects a little bit of pace, drives the ball across. I thought Wallace was going to be in. Misses Main as well. He goes wide. It's a great ball, though, in between defender and goalkeeper.
Yeah, I think from that angle, it looked to be going away from Wallace, all the same. To be fair to him, from our initial angle, he looked just that little bit closer to it. I think it's a free kick. It looks to me like O'Neill. Yes, O'Neill's gone off, and it's Alan Preston now on. Desperately keen to play in this game, as he was to score against his old club in the semi-final.
What a great goal that was.
Here's Kanchelskis again. Did well with that. Wallace shields the ball. Can he turn it in? He gets a corner kick. Well, I think just behind it there, Barry Ferguson wanted the ball played back. suddenly think Guy Bosch was being covered, so that route was blocked off. And Rangers, as I said, they may have had a very indifferent second half, but they now have the ability to go for the kill. They have the players certainly there, if given the right ball to do it. Here's Kanchelskis, there's the shot! That's a great save! Alan made it his very best in having hardly had anything to do in the second half. It's a class goalkeeper against here.
I tell you, what a great save. Great strike from Kanchelskis. And Alan Main, everybody's been talking about Robert Douglas O'Sullivan. Alan Main giving Craig Brown the studio a little more food for thought. Fantastic save from Kanchelskis, Thunder Drive.
Near post one this time, and just touched away. Another corner for Rangers as they turn the screw now. I think realising with less than 10 minutes to go, a goal now would do it, but the referee says that was a goal kick. So the pressure off the Saints there, but they must realise time is running out of them. They made a game of it, made a good final of it. But, you know, in a sense, that's almost damning with faint praise. They've got to do more than that. Where goes Kanchelskis? He's got Wallace up at him now. He's surrounded by white jerseys, though. And it's coming across there away from Guy Bosch. And this is the best phase that Rangers have had in the second half. And we've all about 9 minutes left to play.
Great play by Ron Wallace there. Good. Defenders almost scared to touch him as he drove into the box. You can see the hands are up, they can't touch him as he's running in there. Great cross to the back post, and that's another corner to Rangers.
Tell you what, it was a good cross. I thought, you know, impossible to swing round like that. He's suddenly come alive, Wallace. Near post one again. Not quite sure he actually intended that. Amoroso drives it in. Great control in that wonderful left foot of Newman's. Little piece of football bally there by him.
It hasn't really been in. I mean, it's taken Rangers a good 35 minutes to decide to play, and all of a sudden Newman just reminds us of how good a player he actually is.
Guy Bosch, nice little ball to Wallace. He's got Kanchelskis in there. There was that little bit of hesitation and the cut out by May. This time too near the goalkeeper. Henry just got that away. Ferguson, he's been the linchpin in the last 15 minutes. Since he's come on, he's added stability and a bit of solidity to Rangers midfield. There he goes, Zavaruso in one of these little tours organized by the National Geographic Society. I think he just wanders away. You don't know where he's going to finish up.
Just keeping us on our toes right to the very end.
Ferguson. Van Bronckhorst happy to put that away to Wallace. Is he going after it? He is. Gary Bullen's in there, and Wallace getting it down. Now that came off head. Wallace was complaining to the referee. Yeah, he did.
Actually, good defending by Gary Bowling, because Wallace had him under a lot of pressure. When you're running towards your goalkeeper, it's not easy. A great touch back by Gary.
Intended there for Kanchelskis, so when he's got it back, didn't expect that. He's letting fly with that left foot of his. Precisely what he did against Aberdeen a couple of weeks ago to change the game for Rangers at about precisely the same time.
Yeah, you have, and Rangers again seem to be a button they press. They just up the tempo, realising they need to just get another one to put this game out of St Johnstone's reach.
Well, they're certainly taking the time about it. These two have got a cross there to take all the corner kicks. By Barry Ferguson, will he take it directly? Swings it again, the near post one. Here's Kanchelskis. Well, that sometimes is a difficult ball to achieve. And I think Roddy Grant is about to come on. It looks like Shimao's coming off, yes. I think he's run the legs off himself, the wee fella.
Yeah, he's done really well. Not easy for him. He maybe didn't just give Rangers as much problems as we thought he would. And well, big Roddy Grant coming on.
Whatever has happened to Rangers, it's not by a long, long way not been the best performance of the season. Nowhere near the performance of the second half against Parma, but they and the supporters now beginning to sense that the first trophy of the season isn't far away from their clutches. I make it less than 5 minutes. And I think all 22 players have sensed that, and Rangers have had the benefit of that thought now because it's getting out of St Johnstone's reach.
Well, they've really got to go for it now, St Johnstone. They may have to take a little bit of a chance and leave a few spaces at the back. Trying to get the ball up to Roddy Grant and Lowes to put them under a little bit of pressure, Rangers, but it's Rangers, if anything, that are finishing the stronger.
Well, Ferguson gives that away. Not as sharp at a ball as he ought to have been. Grant coming in. Perini and Ferguson again. What a rejuvenation this man has had since Dick Advocaat has come to the side there. Sendri. No chances there. Well, if he can take on a goalpost at Ibrox the other day, then running against an opponent is nothing to him. It's coming to an end. Cairn Saints clutches game back. Van Bronckhorst goes. Now Newman. Ibosh. Sees Ferguson square. What a difference he's made. Actually finding his own colleagues. Ferguson. Didn't that time. Lowndes. Hammer surrender danger. That was good reading by the big fella that time. Suddenly Roddy Grant had got away from his defender. There's a corner kick. This could be interesting. Here we go. And that vast concourse, the Rangers supporters, I think, at Celtic Park are now beginning to sit on the edges of the seat. 2-1 it is. And the big men are up. Darren Dodds, Canahan, away to the far side, and up will go Henry. There's a little effort there by Dodds. He's not been one of the great finishers in the business. Very good in the air. We saw him scoring against Kilmarnock recently, but not by foot.
Well, he's done well since he's moved to St Johnstone. You're right, the big guys were up there. And I just thought as it was dropping to him, you see Henry here trying to get away, and Darren getting a turn. That could easily have sneaked in. Niemi had everything under control.
And we've just had a substitution. Ibosh has gone off and Gordon Jury is coming on for this remainder of the game. Gordon Jury, who played 13 years ago in a League Cup final for Hibs. He could have done with his pace. Don't think there's any doubt about that. Arthur Newman couldn't quite get hold of it though. Van Bronckhorst, look at the pace of Van Bronckhorst. They get another corner kick. Rangers under pressure now. The lead is minimal. Everybody will crowd into the box again. This is going to be as congested as nearby Parkhead Cross as Kane is going to chip this in. Up it goes again, and there is Niemi. And having said all we've said and praised St Johnstone for the possession they've had, that goalkeeper there said hardly anything to do in the game.
No, they really just haven't had enough guns to try and get Rangers at the back. And I mean, okay, that the chances they've had have been few and far between. And you're right, Archie, Niemi has done nothing in the second half.
McQuillan just got off now. Van Bronckhorst. Plenty space here for Kanchelskis' pace, and he's using it. He has Gordon Jury in the far side, and he'll get it. Jury trying to get to the outside, and he does, and touched away. Oh, bad ball there by Grant. What a waste at this stage. Here's Kunchelskis. Perini. Ian Ferguson, a little bit of space here for Newman. We're into stoppage time. Wallace. Ferguson. Amoruso will play the long ball. Gary Boland should have been covered but didn't. Kunchelskis almost sneaked in behind there.
I think Gary thought Alan Main was coming out to get that.
Perini. And the back of the Rangers players' minds there, the winning of the cup. Not simply the scoreline or increasing it. They want to hold the ball as long as they can. Dasovic, by the way, Nick Dasovic is the man of the match. Could hardly argue with that. And you can hear the Rangers support in the background anticipating the 21st win by Rangers in this tournament. They've only ever lost six of the finals they appeared in. And the final whistle is gone. Rangers have won the League Cup. The first trophy of the season goes to Ibrox. It has been hard fought. Rangers deserve it. On the statistics, you cannot argue with that. They were below form. Some players individually well below par. But at the end of the day, they put the ball in the back of the net when it counted. Now, here's the goal that mattered. A beautiful little 1-2 here by a man eventually went off. Givash onto George Albert, 2-1. So do join us for the presentation after the break as we leave Celtic Park just for a moment. We'll be back with Rangers having won the League Cup. Welcome back to Celtic Park. Archie McPherson looking down on the scene, the boos up for the referees. They're accustomed to it and accustomed to winning the Rangers support. Never let it be said that they get fed up winning things in an old firm setting. The more the better, as I said right at the start, the 21st League Cup victory and the cup, the trophy, about to be presented by Sam Galbraith as the Rangers players seem to be a little bit reluctant up there top left. And I think they're coming up now, the captain of the side, the gentleman who adds such originality to the game, Lorenz Amoruso with the cup. A vast Ranger support has turned up this afternoon. There's a little touch of it here as that cup ceremonially passed down the players. Colin Henry, I wonder if the touch of silver will be an adjustment to stay further on at Ibrox, if there is any truth in the rumours about him moving. And you know, in balancing the game out, Alan McInally sitting beside me, we've paid a great deal of credit to St Johnson for the way they kept the ball off Rangers in the second half, but you know, when the dust has settled, they never actually looked like beating Rangers.
No, the second half, actually, to be fair, Archie, was very, very poor. And at times, I think even 20 minutes before the end of the game, I think Rangers had almost settled to win the cup 2-1. And St Johnson really couldn't put them under any sort of pressure at all. And Niemi was redundant in the second half. But statistics say, you know, the three magnificent goals, I must admit, Albert's is a good enough goal to win any competition. And congratulations, Rangers.
And, you know, a special cheer there for Ian Ferguson, who said his fifth League Cup final, but he came in and he injected not just the kind of spirit that these Rangers supporters want of somebody playing in today a red jersey, but a blue jersey normally, but technique as well. He stemmed St Johnson in the middle of midfield, one possession and spray the ball about, which is what they badly needed.
Well, absolutely. And I mean, Ato is a very, very good player, but he can put it about as well. But you've got to say that it was a pretty below-par performance by Rangers, really. And but having said that, they did enough to win the cup, and that's all you need to do. It doesn't matter how bad you play. If you get to a cup final and you lift the silverware, that's what goes down in the books.
Well, you know, we said at the start that Rangers have a whole series of priorities. They regard the winning of the championship as priority number one, doing as well as they can in Europe, priority number two. But if they've now got the first trophy of the season, that must be a great psychological boost to this club. A club, by the way, that's been revolutionised by Dick Advocaat. There's no question, as the Rangers supporters pick up the refrain of simply the best. And Gordon Jury just getting a little touch of something that eluded him 13 years ago.
I think what you said as well, Archie, about Dick Advocaat revolutionised Rangers. You know, they haven't been together very long.
And that's significant. You know, he's got a lot of...
Absolutely, and he says they're going to get stronger, and I'm sure there'll be no more happier man than Dick Advocaat, the manager of Rangers tonight. He's been here that short term, and already, as Wim Jansen did last year with Celtic, pick up the League Cup.
Well, you know, when he left, Dick Advocaat led his troops out of the stadium last Saturday. It was a bit like Napoleon's retreat from Moscow, and you wondered, how do they recover from this? Listen to that. They're enjoying themselves, whereas last Saturday it was a different scenario. And now we can go to listen to Barry Ferguson.
Barry, magnificent atmosphere, and you have your first winner's medal with Rangers. How does it feel?
Oh, unbelievable. I've always dreamt of doing this, so I've done it, and I'm proud.
How much were the players up for this, considering you'd already beaten St Johnston 7-0 in the league match?
Yeah, we knew it would have been tough. No? We beat them 4-1, I think, at 4-1 at the start of the season, then 7-0, so we expected a tough game.
You obviously got that crucial goal early on, the side must have settled down, but fair play to your opponents, they came back at you.
I always knew that, there are a lot of good players in their team, but we were better.
This is a new Rangers side, do you feel as if this is the start of something big, possibly a treble?
Hopefully, we're all dying to get the treble, I mean, hopefully we can get it.
All the best, enjoy yourself.
Well, there we are, that's Barry Ferguson. I come from a different age where they knew how to wear a baseball cap. Put the front peak in it, and a delighted young man, a man, as you said, with a great career. He wasn't at his best today, like many of the Rangers players, but the potential greatly there.
I think it'll be fair to say that that young man will have to buy a big cabinet, because I'm sure he'll have plenty more medals to add to it.
Well, there they are, done there, and there's going to be a fair amount of enjoyment. Alan, and on an occasion like this, thinking of what's to come for Rangers, and a mighty, mighty game for them against Parma. At least, at the very least, they've got this out of the way.
Well, the game coming up in a fortnight time is quite honestly the biggest game Rangers have had in a decade. I know if you go back to the Marseille days, it was big, yeah, but you know, in the competition they're in now, I think this is a bigger game, and they are playing the favourites for the competition, and that, I'm sure, will be an absolute cracker of a game, no question.
Well, I think I noticed that perhaps the biggest cheer of all as a cup was passed down was not for this man here, who's certainly contributed a great deal, but to Ian Ferguson, and Colin Henry turned to the support, gave them a clenched fist salute there, as if to say, I'm staying on. And here is one gentleman who's decided to come on. It's Arthur Newman.
Seems quite happy, doesn't it?
It does indeed. The vice, a gem of a man too, and a very good athlete. Acting now like a young boy, he's been given a
Superman,
a gift by his auntie. Well, Arthur Newman played, you might recall a game he played in the World Cup against Argentina, and I thought very unfairly sent off in that game, and it did affect him. He played in the third place game that I did in the stadium, and there's Guy Varche, who might have scored that very clean cut goal. Are you fully convinced about Guy Bachelet yet?
Well, maybe not yet, but we will go down because Peter is speaking to Fergie.
Ian, obviously delighted Rangers getting a 21st victory in the League Cup, but the commentator Archie McPherson says it was your crucial substitution that really kind of solidified Rangers' lead in this game.
Oh, I felt the boys were always on top, and that's very nice of them actually to say that, but the boys, I felt they were always in control and they played really well.
Yeah, this is your fifth League Cup final. What does it mean to you to still be a part of this club?
I'm absolutely delighted. I celebrated that there as if it was my first, and I absolutely enjoyed it.
What about the game itself? Because it didn't go according to plan.
No, you know, we get a goal early doors and the boys played, started off really well, and then they come back at us and score right away, which was a bit of a blow for us. But the boys played really well. It shows a lot of determination and character. They got the goal that's won the cup for us, and that's it.
It's been a difficult 7 or 8 days, that traumatic result against Celtic, the Parma game, but you've really bounced back, and testimony to the fans have come out and they've supported you.
The fans have been absolutely magnificent. I must thank them a lot. They've been absolutely magnificent for us. You mentioned the Celtic game, that's in the past now. We're here again, we've won the cup. Parma game's in the past, we played well in the second half. It's all about today, and we've got the cup, and that's the main thing.
You've been involved in the two transitional sides of Rangers. How crucial is it for the manager to get this result?
Oh, it's very important because we didn't win anything last year, and it's always nice to get the first trophy under your belt.
Enjoy your day.
Thank you.
Yes, talking about Dick Advocaat winning the cup, his sixth cup final, and he's only won two of them as a player, as a manager, and as I said, psychologically, he's now over that very important barrier, Alan.
Most definitely, yeah, and as I said already, I think he'll be probably the happiest man in the stadium tonight. You come as a manager, and remember, there's under a lot of pressure, Archie. He is expected to bring them success here at Rangers, not only domestically, but in the European situation as well. And for him to come so early, get the first piece of silverware, we'll be very happy. And another thing, it's good for Rangers. They're going into the big game, they could go into it with confidence now. Well done, them.
Absolutely, a long season to come. The Championship is going to be one of the hottest races we've had in a long time. And Rangers, I think, have confirmed the view that they are a new force, new players, but with the same old objective to win, as they've done the first trophy of the season, the League Cup. I hand you back now to the studio, and to Jim Delahunt.
Thank you very much, Archie, Mark Haitley and Craig Brown, watching the match from the studio here with me. Mark, a lot of people knock this tournament, but there's some very happy Rangers players out in the pitch there.
Absolutely. I think Fergie, you know, hit the nail on the head there by saying they won nothing last year, and it's always very important to get the first one out of the way. I think there's been a lot of pressure on them from the start, the amount of changes they've had in the team. And to go out and win today will breed confidence. You know, show today everybody's celebrating, everybody's enjoying it, the fans are up on the feet. You know, it's just a great day for the Rangers people.
A word for the losers, Craig. Nick Dazovic getting the Man of the Match award, fully deserved, we think. And they played particularly well in the second half, but not many shots on goal, really.
No, they did. I thought they came out and they squeezed the game up. They were 10 yards too deep, 15 yards too deep in the first half, I felt, and a lot of space for the Rangers midfield players. They closed it up and they certainly took the initiative. Paul Kane had a great chance, well, a great shot from the edge of the box. Now, had that sneaked in, we might have had a different ending to the game. But a good fight from St Johnstone, great credit to them. They played very, very well, up against everything. But I thought Sandy Clark can hold his head high, and I'm sure his players will continue in the league to do very well.
Absolutely, gentlemen. We'll talk more in a minute, but let's get to a break right now. Join us again in a couple of minutes for a look back at how Rangers won the Scottish League Cup. Don't go away.